Hey guys, here to do an update. Bear with me, it's going to be a huge update. So yeah, I'm just going to start with the Arrow Blu rays first. We have the Black Cat, Lucio Fulci movie. Actually a solid, not very talked about Lucio Fulci movie. It has David Warbeck in it, and it's pretty solid. Came out in his heyday in between stuff like, you know, Zombie and New York Ripper and whatnot. But we have Blood and Black Lace. This is like a two-disc set. It's freaking nice. And this is a Mario Bava movie. This movie's awesome as well. Also reviewed it, really dig it. Your Vice is a Locked Room, and I only have The Key, which is Sergio Martino movie. Also reviewed it, pretty solid stuff. It's got Luigi Pistelli in it. The Strange Case of Dr. Jekyll and Miss Osborne. This is a what's the guy's name, Valerian Bojdelicek. I can't say his name, just give me a break guys. But this movie's really bizarre, kind of surreal sexual fetishism with Dr. Jekyll and Mrs. Hyde. Udai Kier's in it, a bunch of people are in it. I really enjoyed it as well. Also reviewed that one. Mark of the Devil. This is a classic German film with Herbert Lahm in it, and Udai Kier again. I always like this one, witchcraft torture, kind of my thing. And those old, I love those movies that take place as timepieces, but are also horror movies. And the witchcraft deal and the fake witch scare always kind of intrigued me, being a piece of history, you know. I thought it was kind of just one of the weirdest things on earth to have happen. Island of Death, this is what's the guy's name, I can't think of, Niko Makarakis. He's a Greek guy. This ended up on the Video Nasties list. This is a pretty crazy movie as well. That's it. These are all Blu-rays from Arrow. Most of them are US, otherwise I'll state. But Island of Death is just ultimate like taboo breaker, really weird. And today watching it is just so bizarre. I also really like that one. A Day of Anger, which is a spaghetti western, is Lee Van Cleef. Also I reviewed this one, pretty cool stuff. Can't go wrong with that guy. Pit Stop, which is a Jack Hill movie. Actually never saw it. This one actually is approved by the director. There is a Code Red one out there as well. Not seeing that one. Microwave Massacre. I love this movie. Jackie Vernon in it. Really silly. Killing people. Making jokes. Kind of like Rodney Dangerfield / Frosty Snowman as a serial killer. Eating. Cutting up and eating women. We have one here. Sheba Baby. Never saw this one. Blaxploitation. Pam Grier. Can't go wrong with her. Spider Baby. Another Jack Hill movie. This movie's pretty much a damn classic. Anybody that's ever seen this one would agree. Good stuff, good stuff. Lon Chaney Jr. and, you know, our early performance by Sid Haig. The Beast, also the guy who did The Strange Case of Dr. Jekyll and Mrs. Hyde. Yeah, I like this movie as well. Again, takes the story of a bunch of people trapped in this weird kind of, well, not trapped, but secluded in this castle, and there's supposed to be a wedding going on, but there might just be something wrong with the groom. Immortal Tales. This is the one I have not seen by that director, but yeah, it's supposed to be a bunch of little tales on there. Kind of interested in seeing that one as well, because I've liked his other two films I've seen. Slugs. This is by the director of Pieces. Yeah, this movie is ridiculously stupid. If anybody's seen it, you guys know it. Very funny. There's a great gag in here with a guy who eats one of the slugs and the parasites, the little worms explode in his eyes. The Bloodstained Butterfly, Giallo I watched, pretty good stuff. Helmut Berger's in it. I love him in his version of The Secret Life of Dorian Gray. We have Contamination, which is by Luigi Cozzi. This is a solid movie, also with Ian McCall, who's in Zombie Holocaust. Yeah, not a bad movie at all, just kind of schlocky, and it does pretty much dead stop in the middle of the movie for a while. Hills Have Eyes by Wes Craven. What can I say? I haven't had a chance to watch the new Arrow edition, but yeah, that's a freaking classic, and I've always enjoyed it myself. I know some people feel a little mixed about it nowadays. What else do we have? We have I actually picked up Arrow UK was having a sale, so I made some cheap, they're pretty cheap, like I said, Django Prepare the Coffin. This is an import. Have not seen this one, but it's Django. The Deep Red, the 4K one, supposed to look great. I'm excited to see it. I haven't watched this movie in years. This is Dario Argento, of course. Dario Argento, you know, sometimes I talk so fast I don't say names properly at all. And I do apologize for that. But Frankenhooker, I do have the Synapse. I don't know if this one's any better, but yeah, I wanted to check it out. Frankenhooker is one of my favorites. Well, Heenan Ladder is one of my favorites in general. That's not my favorite Heenan Ladder, but I like it. Nightmare City, I heard this cut, this edition is better than the what is it, Raro edition, and I love this movie. It's one of my favorite, just like, schlocky B-zombie movies from Italy. Obsession, I believe is a Brian De Palma. Have not watched this one either. Wasn't very expensive. The Honeymoon Killers. This is actually by Criterion here, but it was very cheap, like $5-$6 on Blu-ray or something like that, so why not? Remo Williams, also very cheap. Have not seen it. Fred Ward's the man. Always love Fred Ward. Can't go wrong. along with him. We have Theater of Blood with Vincent Price. This is actually one of my favorite Vincent Price movies. This is the one where he kills people by these critics of his by Shakespearean deaths. Really fun. Makes the guy eat his own dogs. I love how I said that with a gleeful smile. But Vincent Price is the only guy that can make that fun. I don't know how. But Forbidden Zone. This is also released stateside. But yeah, this movie is batshit crazy. And I actually, by Richard Elfman, Danny Elfman's brother from Oingo Boingo. Cool movie for sure. Now we're going to hop into the Shout Scream Factory stuff. Narcolepsy, basically, I've not seen this. Looks bizarre. It was cheap. They had a sale. The Squad also was on sale. Well, they were at a sale. Ejecta, not seen this one. Very cheap. The Exorcist 3, never saw The Exorcist 3. The only Exorcist I've actually seen is the first one. And I think Dominion in theaters back in the day. But yeah, I'm excited to see that. It has both cuts on there, the director's cut. Women's Prison Massacre was dirt cheap. Bruno Mattei movie. I guarantee you the Woman in Prison movie by him is going to be ridiculously stupid. The Thing. What can you say about The Thing? This is the new remastered edition from Scream Factory. I'm going to tell you, The Thing's one of the best horror movies ever made, in my opinion. I love it. Tale of Tales. This looked crazy. Had monster in it in the trailer. Just looked bizarre. Heard good things about it. Baskin. I love this movie. Turkish horror movie reminded me of Fulci and surreal and dreamlike and gory and just bizarre and weird. Uses a cue, music cue from Cannibal Holocaust. Kind of won me over. I love the villain in it. He's just so bizarre and creepy and he has a weird aura about him. I really enjoyed Baskin. That was one of my favorites I saw this year. The Duke of Burgundy. I heard this is kind of an interesting, weird movie. Shocker was on sale. I grabbed this. Wes Craven, kind of a stupid classic. The Bite, not watched this one yet. Heard mixed things, really. Return of the Living Dead, again, one of my all-time favorite movies, top five. Love Return of the Living Dead. Looks great on the new Blue, too. Death Wish 2, both cuts, the unrated and the theatrical cut. I've only, I actually most familiar with the theatrical cut, I guess. I love this movie. Just corny revenge, Bronson being Bronson. I really love Death Wish 2. Invasion of the Body Snatchers. I've not had a chance to rewatch this, but I remember this. In fact, all the two Body Snatchers movies in the 50s and 70s are both excellent. This one, no different. Donald Sutherland, Jeff Goldblum, great cast. Love that movie, actually. Hellhole. I've not had a chance to watch this. I watched a few minutes of it. Really dumb. Captain America. I don't know why I bought this. Looked silly. Looked fun. Session 9. That movie's really freaky, really enjoyable stuff. The Boy Who Cried Werewolf, have not had a chance to watch this one. All Quiet on the Western Front. This looks very like a dramatic war film. Looks pretty good. The Outing and Godsend. Yeah, I remember The Outing quite a bit. Haunted Lamp in a Museum. Saw that as a kid. Have not watched The Godsend yet. The Boys from Brazil. Not seen this one either. Was interested in it. Tentacles and Reptilicus. Tentacles is really silly, has a good cast, has a really good score in it, not such a great movie. Cellar Dweller and Catacombs. Seen Cellar Dweller, it's okay. Interested in seeing Catacombs. Some vampire ones. I'm Madman. This movie's cool, guys. It's been a long time since I watched it, but the same director of The Gate. I haven't watched the Blu-ray yet, but I remember the DVD and being pretty entertained by it. The Funhouse Massacre. I've not seen this. It's got a cast of, you know, like the typical kind of guys in there that go to convention, like Clint Howard, and it's got Robert Englund, stuff like that. I see Ed Begley Jr.'s in there too. But Bad Moon. Rewatch this one. Yeah, it's still pretty fun. I always liked it a lot. That was underrated. Now I think it's where it should be after rewatching it. Here we go, some more from Severin. The Stuntman, not watched this. Devil Hunter / Cannibal Terror. Yeah, I have not watched these ever at the DVD. They look really silly. I think they both might have made it on the Video Nasty list, at least the Section 3. Turkey Shoot, aka Escape 2000, or is it 3000? This movie's really cool, actually. Australian exploitation film. Inglourious Basterds, classic movie, pretty cool stuff. The Hot Nights of Linda, not had a chance to watch this one. Thirst, again, not watched this one. Australian vampire movie, I believe. Dr. Butcher, MD, aka Zombie Holocaust. Man, Severin really went all out in this one. Looks great, tons of features. Reviewed this one. Love that movie. Love what they did with it. Here's another one they did a great job with. Burial Ground. Love this movie. Love what they did with it. Very good. In the vein of something, like I said, like Nightmare City or Hell of the Living Dead or Zombie 3, which I love all those movies deeply. Basket Case 3, really cool to see it released on stateside Blu-ray. Fun, stupid Heenan Lotter. 2, or is this 2? Yeah, 2's even better. I think 2's probably the most fun out of all of them. Tons of freaks, tons of silliness. Really like it. Just Desserts to Make Making of Creepshow by Michael Felcher. Yeah, really great doc, especially if you love Creepshow. Manos, Hounds of Fate, never watched this one. Or is it Manos? I'm not sure. Most people pronounce it Manos. It's supposed to be the worst movie ever, so I was never so intrigued to really watch it. The Long Weekend, kind of a slow burn animal eco horror movie. I haven't seen it in years. Tenebrae. This is another Dario Argento, the standard edition. Love that movie. One of my favorite giallos. Reviewed it as well. The Treatment, reviewed this one as well. Really great from Artsploitation Films. I'd really recommend this one. Really good thriller. Actually very disturbing and bothersome. Children of the Night, not had a chance to watch this one from Artsploitation. Der Bunker by Artsploitation. I actually dug this one. Pretty cool movie. Pretty bizarre, absurdist kind of comedy. We have The Perfect Husband from Italy from Artsploitation Films. Not a big fan of this one. Thought it was really kind of poorly acted and just poorly written. Observance, I didn't feel this one was... It was well made. It's just that the script just didn't go anywhere. It's kind of a big waste of time. Kind of creepy, but just not incompetent. Just boring. What do we got? We got Hunters. Probably not best spot there. Hunters by Adam Albrandt. I actually am in this movie. Check it out if you like extreme kind of rapey movies. We got a few from this Real Gore releasing that just came out. Violent Shit, the movie. This is a remake of Violent Shit. Remade in Italy with Giovanni Ridici, which is kind of strange considering like it's like they remade Violent Shit, A. B, in Italy, a German splatter movie they remade. And it sounds, it's worse. Like, I don't want to be a dick, but it has good music, has a good amount of nudity, but this is, the gore's not really there. It's just kind of a more talky than it should be. This is another one from Real Gore. This is Mask. This movie's actually pretty cool. Very giallo-like, has this good gore. Definitely reminds me of Italian-style stuff. That one's cool. I recommend that one. And The Curse of Dr. Wolfenstein. If you're a big German splatter fan, this one's pretty much a must. Review coming soon. Tons of gore. Just splatter and gore everywhere in it. A lot of them machete tricks, so like 60 people die with machete blood trick. It's like, it's so gory that it actually got old. We have some Criterion, Fantastic Planet, animated movie, supposed to be really crazy. Not actually seen that, been wanting to see it for years. Eraserhead, one of my all-time favorites by David Lynch, Blu-ray, great stuff. Dr. Strangelove and How I Learned to Love the Bomb, Stop Worrying and Learn to Love the Bomb. This is Stanley Kubrick, obviously one of the best dark comedies ever made, hilarious. Valerie and Her Week of Wonders, not had a chance to watch this one. I believe it's from Czechoslovakia, always wanted to see it. And David Lynch's Mulholland Drive, always heard good things about it, never had a chance to watch it. We have some from Raro Films here. We have The Long Hair of Death, which I believe is a giallo. I'm not 100% sure. I'm not seeing this movie. But yeah, Antonio Margheriti directed it, who did Naked You Die and Cannibal Apocalypse, one of my all-time favorite movies. We have Massacre or Sacrifice, a.k.a. Deep River Savages or Man from Deep River, which is a Umberto Lenzi movie, a cannibal adventure movie. It has a scene of cannibalism in there, which kind of kick-started the cannibal genre. I always remember that movie being fairly solid. Death Curd Last Night. And what else do we got? Slaughter Hotel with Klaus Kinski. Iguana by Monty Hellman. What else do we got here? We got the SRS Truth or Dare by Tim Ritter. This is just released. Yeah, that movie's really goofy. I always enjoyed it. Gorgasm. I actually dug this one. I watched it. Fairly good. SOV stuff. Dead Silence by the same director. Not had a chance to watch one. Hugh Gallagher. Killing Spree also by Tim Ritter. This one has the super long edition on there. That's why I got it. Killing Spree's goofy and fun. Tim Ritter, Deadly Dares, Truth or Dare 4. Need to watch this one. I had seen it when it came out on DVD, I think. But that one might be a different edition. Channel 13 by the Poloni Brothers. I'm not sure how they say it. Death Reel, also by them. It's a lot of SRS stuff. A Lethal Nightmare and Hallucinations by them. Church of the Damned and what is this one? Bad Magic. Double feature. What else do we got? All right, here we go. Got some Code Red, Mark of the Witch. Running Scared. John Saxon in there. Mutant. I haven't watched this in years. Lord Shango. Headhunter, watched this recently. I had seen it years ago. It's just okay. Great monster, though. Assault on Paradise. Mardi Gras Massacre, which was a Video Nasties kind of a remake of Blood Feast. The Police Connection, not seen this one. Family Honor, interested in watching this one. The Redeemer, this is a slasher movie on Blu-ray. House on the Edge of the Park by Ruggiero Deodato. Love this movie. One of my all-time favorites, so I had to see the Blu-ray. David Hess is in it. Giovanni Ridici again. Really dig that one. Voices from the Beyond, which is a Fulci movie I've actually never seen on Blu-ray. Terror Circus. Heard good things about this one, actually, from the what is it? The what is the Strange and Deadly podcast, is it? Or is it the one? Yeah, or it's that one or the last it's the Strange and Deadly podcast. Zombie Nightmare. This movie's really stupid and goofy. I haven't watched it in years. Trick or Treats. David Carradine. Sweet 16. Remember this being a solid exploitation movie. I haven't seen it in years. Moonshine Express. Again, John Saxon in there. I love John Saxon. Long Ride from Hell. Black Candles. Mission Kill. What else do we got here? Now we have some Scorpion, I believe. A Candle for the Devil. I think this is a Spanish one. Dr. Death, Seeker of Souls. I've always wanted to see this one. Grizzly. This movie's pretty fun, pretty cool stuff. Richard Jekyll in it. Andrew Prine. Hollywood Boulevard by, who did this? Joe Dante. I've always wanted to see this one. Sickest first directed movie. Dogs. Got a good deal on Dogs. Harley Quinn. Australian movie again. Scorpion. The Riff. Also by the guy who did Slugs and Pieces. So yeah, I'm sure that's goofy fun. Savage Weekend. I haven't seen this in years, and I think I saw a cut edition. Canadian Slasher. David Gale. William Sanderson. Planet of the Vampires by Mario Bava. Madhouse with Vincent Price. This one's actually cool. Peter Cushing in that as well. Wolf Lake. Always wanted to see this one. This one looks interesting. Exploitation movie. What else do we got? The Siege of Firebase Gloria. Looks cool. Has Wings Hazard and Lee Ermey in it. The Pit. Love this movie. So glad it's on Blu-ray. They Eat Meat. That's one of my favorites. Just really weird. Queen of Blood. I think it's a Curtis Harrington movie. Yeah. Godzilla 1984. I always thought it was 85, but I guess it's 84. This has the Japanese version on there, which not many people have seen. Death Row Game Show by Vinegar Syndrome. Murder Weapon and Deadly Embrace. Have seen Murder Weapon. I remember it being fairly decent, solid. Leanna Quigley. Hobgoblins. Believe it or not, I love little creature movies. Made a couple little creature movies. Never saw Hobgoblins. Not heard good things, though. So, Nightmare Sisters. Again, it's a bunch of Scream Queens in that one. Old school. Female Werewolf by Chris Alexander. Lake Nowhere. Love this movie. Really cool stuff. Check out the review. We got Clown by Eli Roth. Actually really enjoyed this movie too, surprisingly. I thought it was pretty good. Mother's Day. There's still a little bit of package on there. Yeah, I rewatched that one. Not that great. It's all right though. It's the original. Better than a remake. Freaked. Love this movie. Super stupid. Super fun. Always loved it. Ash vs. Evil Dead Season 1. Watched the first episode to check it out. I didn't think it was terrible. It was all right. It was kind of fun. Cannibal Woman in the Avocado Jungle of Death. Full Moon. Goofy movie. Demolisher. Not seen this one. Looks like a revenge movie from Dark Sky. I'm going to check it out. Magic on Blu-ray. Never seen this one. Have the Blu-ray. Have the DVD. Looking forward to that. And we got What the Peeper Saw. VCI had a sale. Pretty cheap stuff. Gorgo. I haven't watched this since I was a kid. Always liked it as a kid. I don't know if it's going to be any good. Night Visitor. Is that again a Curtis Harrington? No, this is a different one. But this does have a... I want to say Dennis Hopper was in this one. Is it? Is it the one with Dennis Hopper? Not sure. Not sure. That one might be Night Tide. I think it's Night Tide. The Great Giant Spider Invasion. This looks silly. Gotta watch that. The Bird with the Crystal Plumage by Dario Argento. And Dark Star by John Carpenter. Lionsgate. Green Room. Everybody loved it. I'm a big fan of Murder Party and Blue Ruin. I thought that one was okay. I wasn't a huge fan of it. Mojave. Not seen this one either. Saw Collection. You know, I'm never a big fan of Saw, but the collection was dirt cheap. I figured I saw the first one, thought it was okay. Thought the second one, thought it was kind of crummy. I figured I'd check out the rest, just at least maybe see some stupid fun deaths. The Leprechaun Collection was like $15. I know they're not good, but some of them are kind of funny. American Werewolf in London, remastered. This is a classic. Top horror movie I've ever made. 30th anniversary of Highlander. Have not watched this in a while. Thought, why not watch it remastered? Chopping Mall. So cool. Fucking Lionsgate to hop on the bandwagon, man, and start doing the good stuff we wanted to see. Jim Wynorski movie. Chopping Mall has always been fun. Been a long time since I've seen it. Blood Diner. Also been a long time since I've watched this one. Enjoyed it. But I did get a chance to watch Waxwork, which is one of my all-time favorite movies. Waxwork 1 looked okay. I always liked Waxwork 1 and 2, but Waxwork 1 is one of my favorites. I thought the movie looked solid. It looked kind of soft to me. But yeah, it had a bunch of features on there. It was a great release all around. Just some typical Strange Brew, never saw it. Vince Price, House of Wax. Creepshow, classic. Never had the Blu-ray, don't know why. I remember it was bare bones. I was holding out for a special edition. It, which is cool to see it on Blu-ray. Always liked that as a kid. Salem's Lot. Cat's Eye, always liked it as a kid as well. The Haunting. See, I got a lot of stuff that I just needed to pick up for years. Mind Warp. Look at these creatures in the back. That's funny. Gamera Trilogy. William Castle Double Feature, Homicidal, and Mr. Sardonicus. These are the Mill Creeks. 13 Ghosts and 13 Frightened Girls. Hammer Films, The Two-Face of Dr. Jekyll and the Gorgon. The Revenge of Frankenstein and The Curse of the Mummy's Tomb. Cat in the Brain. Lucio Fulci, classic here by Grindhouse. Ridiculous movie. Love it. Venom. This is also a really cool movie with a bunch of Klaus Kinski, Oliver Reed in it. I enjoy that one. Strangers by the Lake. Really like this movie. It's kind of like, some people say, a gay Hitchcockian thriller. Really cool stuff. The Strange Color of the Body, Your Body's Tears. Not had a chance to watch this one. It's supposed to be like a giallo inspired. A lot of people say it's really slow, nonsensical. But Almer, same director. That's their first movie. Shanks. Not had a chance to watch this one. Hard Target. I heard it's the international longer cut. Love this movie. Great Outdoors. It was a Best Buy exclusive. I always love this movie as well. Big John Candy guy. Dream Team. Have not seen this as a kid. Always remember liking this one as well. The Burbs. Yeah, it's The Burbs. One of the best ever. Hands down. Weird Science. I've not seen this in years. Not sure if I even saw the whole thing, actually. It's one of those deals. We have 8-pack Hammer Horror here. We have Brides of Dracula, Curse of the Werewolf, Night Creatures, The Phantom of the Opera, Paranoiac, The Kiss of the Vampire, Nightmare, and The Evil of Frankenstein. The only one I've actually seen on there, I might have seen a couple, The Phantom of the Opera and The Curse of the Werewolf, both, and Brides of Dracula, all of which I've enjoyed. The Neon Demon, not had a chance to watch this. Refn, crazy director. The Invitation, I absolutely love this movie. One of my favorites of the year. Cool stuff. The Wailing. What do we got here? The Mind's Eye. This actually is really fun. Kind of a scanner's thing with bloody good stuff. I enjoy it quite a bit. Ooh, let's do I'm making sounds here. Plank Face. Yeah, you guys should check out Plank Face, to be honest. I had a small role in it, and Brian Williams and Scott Shermer did it. I personally think, I'm biased trying to be, I think they did a pretty good job. I think it's a cool movie. I think people will check it out. Enjoy it. Hocus Pocus. Come on. Halloween classic here. Love it, Disney. Total Recall, one of my all-time favorites as well. Jostom Oz, who doesn't like... I love Arnold, so. The Killer, also an awesome freaking movie. Replacement Killers, Truth and Consequences of New Mexico. Both solid movies. Always liked Truth and Consequences growing up. Once Upon a Time in America, I haven't seen this in years. I'm not sure which cut I actually saw. But, you know, that's Sergio Leone, who did the Spaghetti Western trilogy, and Once Upon a Time in the West, which I love. Don't Fuck in the Woods. Yeah, long time coming. Finally came. Yeah. Checked it out. You know, there's tons of nudity. That's going to be a plus there. I think a lot of people will dig that. Tales of Halloween. This is like the deluxe edition. Like 10 shorts, 13 shorts in here. I watched it, reviewed it years ago. Or a couple years ago. Or a year ago. Enjoyable. I thought it was kind of fun. Atros, which I reviewed as well. Kind of like a Spanish August Underground for the first part. And then kind of goes in its own direction. If you like that kind of snuff stuff, it's pretty cool. Francesca, again, kind of a giallo thing. I think a lot of people will dig this one. I thought it was pretty cool. Check out the review. The Magnificent Seven Collection. 4 movies on here. Magnificent Seven, Return of the Magnificent Seven. Guns of the Magnificent Seven. The Magnificent Seven Ride. Yul Brynner, Charles Bronson, Steve McQueen. Big cast. Alien Quadrilogy. All 4 Alien movies. 2 versions of each film. Pretty cool. Love the Alien movies. Scream 4, I had a chance to watch this. Like Canadian release, was dirt cheap. The Stranger Land, dirt cheap Blu-ray that was at a store for like a dollar. Angel's Crest was like a dollar as well. The Majorettes, yeah, Bill Hinesman directed this one. Shriekshow's back, man. That's kind of weird. I never thought it was going to happen. Bad Biology by Frank Henenlotter by Shriekshow as well. The Ruins, haven't watched in years. Thought was decent. The Ward by John Carpenter, Blu-ray, DVD combo. The remake of Poltergeist, had not had a chance to watch. This is a rental only. The Gift, really loved this movie, thought it was really well made. We're Back, have not seen in years. Fantastic Four, I had not watched it, I just got it dirt cheap. Thumbelina, again, $3, why not? 30 Days of Night, this is Dark Days, this is the sequel. Blue Sunshine, I have not seen in a while. I think this movie by Jeff Lieberman has one of the best setups ever, though. Bad Acid, and then years later you snap. That's a great setup, I haven't watched it in years. The Alien Factor, this is a fun movie if anybody's ever seen it, by Don Doler. And now we got the imports Blu-rays. We got SS Experiment Camp, Video Nasty. Sorority Babes in the Slime Bowl-orama. I heard the sounds better on this edition, so I grabbed it. I haven't seen that in years. The Suckling. Not too big of a fan of this one. Thought it was kind of shitty. But Flesh-Eating Mothers. I thought the monster was kind of cool in it. Zombie Flesh Eaters 2, aka Zombie 3. Love this movie. Super stupid. Super dumb. Bruno Mattei and Lucio Fulci together. Bloodsucking Pharaohs of Pittsburgh. Been a long time. Whoa, sorry. Been a long time since I've seen this one. Always remembered kind of liking it. The Boogeyman. Never actually watched The Boogeyman. Nail Gun Massacre. Really stupid movie here. So, yeah. I figured I'd get the import. It's cheaper than the Code Red. Hollywood Chainsaw Hookers. Not been a long time since. Been a long time since I watched that one, too. And Spider University. Also been years since I watched this one. But what else we got? We got Retribution. Uncut. This is also cheaper to import it than get the Code Red. Andy Warhol's Flesh for Frankenstein. I think it's an upscale, so. But still enjoy the movie. Same thing with Blood for Dracula. Upscale Blu-ray, so. Probably not worth the time. Four Flies on Grey Velvet, Dario Argento again. This is his, like, first giallo. Or is it his first? No. Bird with the Crystal Plumages. That might be the second one. The Greasy Strangler. My God. I just recently watched that. Really funny, really gross, and pretty much, it's very captivating. I enjoyed it a lot. Company of Wolves. Is that Neil Jordan? Is that his name? I believe so. The Candyman. Imported that. Have not seen it in years. Stalker. Heard good things about it. I heard that Criterion might be releasing this, so I don't know. The Wicker Man 3-disc. Also an absolute classic. We have Fright Night 2 Blu-ray. They actually put one in the back, a disc, because people are complaining that the sound was messed up. I bet this is the one with the fixed sound, so that's cool. Love Fright Night 2. Death Dream. Import Blu-ray. This is on there. This is a Bob Clark's best movie, in my opinion. Let me get a better look at that, guys, for you guys. It's a nice hard box, Fright Night 2. Switchblade Sisters, the Jack Hill movie. DVD, Blu-ray, together. Day of the Cobra, DVD, Blu-ray. I think it's just a Blu-ray, just different case, though, in here. But yeah, this is recommended. I saw it on Extra Than the Other channel. The Punisher Extended Cut, Steelbook. Two-disc. Yeah, I rewatched that just recently, and it's fun. It's stupid. Better than the one with John Travolta, but all of them are better than that one. All of them I actually like. I like the Daredevil Season 2. I like Punisher Warzone, and I like that one. I just am not a particular fan of the one with Thomas Jane and John Travolta. Shockma, cheaper to import than get that one. Guyver. And you know, I had complained that all the editions of Guyver were the crappy director's cut with all the gore cut out. This Blu-ray on Amazon Germany, if you go over and get it, I don't know if the new era one's gonna have it or not. It's the extended director's cut, but it has all the gore back in. It's in regular like footage, but it's all spliced back in. So finally, I can watch Guyver in HD. Mad Foxes. I had a chance to watch this. I watched some of it. Pretty exploitative. Pretty stupid, actually. Then we have the Dawn of the Dead Japanese box set. This contains all three editions in there: the Euro, the extended, and the theatrical cut. And a booklet and some other stuff. Yeah, I put it in there. It doesn't look particularly great, but, you know, I was tired of waiting for one of my favorite movies to get on Blu-ray in the States here. Let's get into the DVDs. The Canal. Really fun Irish movie. Not fun. It's miserably scary and gross, but really good Irish movie. Don't like the cover very much. What is this? Vile Prey was sent to this review. Wasn't a huge fan of it. All Hallows Eve 2. Lost in the Sun. Creature Feature, reviewed this one, thought it was alright. What is this one? Replicator, Clone to Kill. And Poltergeist, Season 1. Remember this show? I don't. Vaguely. Dangerous Babes, 12 set. Just checking the time, guys, sorry. Plank Face, I actually came with awesome trading cards as well. Metal Beast, yeah, it's the German import. That's a fun movie. The Zombie King. Edward Furlong and Corey Feldman and Zombies. Shark Exorcist by Donald Farmer. Cut Her Out. You cut it out. I'm just kidding. But The Hoarder. Huh. Kind of relate to that title right now. Here we go. 12 Unit Show Nothing. Hotter Than Hell. Come Deadly Down Holy Child. This is like the Bizarre Art Theater from... it has like 12 movies on there for Vinegar Syndrome. Don't Fuck in the Woods DVD. Feast for those with an appetite for flesh. Shakatan, widescreen, Garden of Death, and Shriek of the Mutilated. Got it for Garden of Death, remastered. I like that movie. Grew up watching it. It's pretty stupid. The Big F reviewed it. Really silly movie by Nathan Rumler and company. Monsterland, watched some of it. Not into it at all. Mansion of the Doomed by Full Moon. Oh, okay. Yeah, these are some German splatter I got. I don't even know what that says. Limbles? Limbless? Legion of the Dead? This is Olaf Inbach, I believe. Aberration? So you have that one there. Manson's Lost Girls. Flesh Freaks, Dead Hunter. The Hallow. I don't know if I have this on Blu-ray or DVD, but I thought it was okay. Frankenstein. Creep. No, I thought Creep was pretty creepy, actually. End of the Damned and Night of Fear. We have Mar Negro, a.k.a. Black Sea. This is by the guys over at, what are their names? Black Fables, I believe. Yeah, this movie's pretty crazy. The opening and the ending are amazing. It's from Brazil, I think. Cool stuff. Zombie World. Shock Cinema. Volume 1 through 4. Beyond Remedy. The Aftermath. Crime of Passion. Murder Set Pieces. Import Spanish Edition. The Extended with everything in it. So, yeah, cool. House of Cuckoo Lane. Viewed that one as well. The Parasite Doctor. Suzanne. Genesis. Massacre Up North. Shot on video. Ebola Zombies. Cheap. Beyond Dream's Door or Director's Cut. Love this movie. I never saw the Director's Cut. It's from Ohio. I think they made it in Ohio years ago. Dug that movie. Cell Count. Mechanics. Unearthed Films. Pretty cool movie. A lot of stop motion. The Girl from Cortina. Gross House. And that's pretty much what it is. Reviewed that one. Fabulous Negras, which is an anthology film by the guys who did Black Sea. Not had a chance to watch it. Or yeah, I can't show this one. Zombie Reanimator. Hard Box. Wicked City. Live action version of Wicked City. Guys, a little bit of a crazy here. We have Beyond the Limits, Olaf Inbach. All Hell Breaks Loose. I watched that one. Biker kind of, it was alright. Survival Knife. Not watched that. Hole. Years since I watched this. I reviewed it. I had mixed feelings about it. Turnpike Killer. Reviewed that. Thought it was okay. The Wife Killer from Mondo Macabro. Looked interesting. Medusa. I believe they're both Greek movies, so yeah, I'm interested in checking those out. Necrophagia Through the Eyes of the Dead. Not really a big fan of this type of music, but the music videos are awesome. Some are directed by Jim Van Bever as well. That's a massacre video. Come and see. Heard this is like the most bleak war movie ever. Wanted to check it out. Nutsack. This is not to be confused with Nutsack Lucifer's whatever by James Bell. But James Bell's a madman. He makes shot on video movies. Shot on video movies are pretty crazy. He has guts and puts guts all over the case too. I had a small role in this. I thought it was really fun. I thought James Bell does unique, crazy stuff, and he's got guts, man. We have New Blood Awakening. Upside Down Cross. Reviewed that one as well. Accidental Incest by Richard Griffin. Love Richard Griffin. That one's funny. A Garden of Love by Olaf Inbach as well. Tupla, which I actually have a U.S. version of this as well. Now, Fever by Artsploitation. Not a huge fan of this one. Thought it was kind of... I'm not sure what their point was. Frog Dreaming. I believe this is AKA The Quest in the States. And we have... what is this one called? Mutation. German Splatter as well. Demonium. Paris by Night of the Living Dead. Primordis, Lord of the Living Dead. Actually had that edition. These are doubles. Black Past. That movie's really fun. I think Massacre's doing that one. And this is a Burning Moon edition of that, which I did not have that edition. What else do we got? Creeper. Reviewed that one. Thought it was pretty decent. Like the guy who plays the Creeper. He's really good in it. Southbound. Not had a chance to watch it. Anthology. Psychic Experiments. Got this because Marcus Cook does the effects in it. Heard this pretty crazy effects. Thanks again, Josh Ward. Sorry about that. Dark Universe, Biohazard 2, and Jacko. Thanks, man, for this. Pretty cool stuff. 4 Mills for Zombies. Reviewed that one. Mixed feelings on it. Sodomaniac. Lots of fun. Really stupid slasher movie. Enjoyed the hell out of it. The Final Act. Let's go on the VHS. The 555 Slipcase by Massacre. Necrophagia Through the Eyes of the Dead. VHS. And Hunter's VHS. And let's just end it out with 2 Laserdiscs. Japanese import of The Kindred. Yeah, this one got beat to shit, but I think this is probably going to be the best quality looking Japanese Laserdisc. The Kindred's a cool movie, guys. Man at the Moon. Never heard about this one. Remembered the cover. I remember after when I saw the cover, I remembered it, but never really read into it. Didn't know much about it. But yeah, Laserdisc. It looks kind of like a low-key werewolf movie. But sorry if any of that was out of focus or it was just hectic. I mean, that was a lot of stuff. Had to get through it. Thanks, guys. Also, hey, go follow the link all the way in the bottom of the description box to watch the Halloween Spookies, which me and Dustin Mills directed. It's free. Check it out. It's family-friendly. It's goofy. There's three stories in there with a wraparound. Bunch of familiar faces if you've watched any of Dustin's movies or Slimy Little Bastards. Take care.